The leader of a Philippine civic group being investigated for alleged abuses, suspected to be a mere puppet of powerful figures. Let's hear more from Sherrianne Torres.
Both Senators Riza Ontiveros and Ronald De La Rosa, who are leading the investigation of the Socorro Bayanihan Services Incorporated, have a similar suspicion. The group's 22-year-old president, Jerenz Quilario, more known as Señor Aguila to his followers, who is reportedly a reincarnation of the child Jesus, is being used and manipulated by people who are actually behind the group. Ontiveros, in fact, sees Mamerto Galanida as the one who influences Quilario the most. Galanida, who is now confined in a Manila-based hospital, is a former school division superintendent, a three-time mayor of the Socorro Municipality, and a three-term board member of Surigao del Norte.
Lima talaga yung pinakamakapangyarihang tao doon sa kapihan, kabilang sina Señor Aguila at Mamerto Galanida. Pero nung tinanong ko, sa lahat nila, sino ang pinakamakapangyarihan, lumabas na sa sense niya, ha, si Mr. Galanida nga. Pero pareho silang liable sa kung anong mapatunay mga krimeng ginawa, lalo na dun sa mga bata.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa, whose committee is also investigating the SBSI, believes Señor Aguila is just a front man.
Si Jerenz Quilario, alias popular known as Señor Aguila, ay ginamit lang itong printe. Ginamit itong figurehead ng organisasyon in order to get adherence, no, ng mga policies, lahat ng mga decision making ng SBSI ay hindi niya personal na kwan, hindi siya ang nagde-decide, kundi yung grupo advisor niya na sa likod niya na sinusunod niya yung mga advices.
Still, Quilario cannot be classified as the least guilty since he is the one issuing orders. Aside from Galanida, others who sit as Quilario's advisors are businessman Karen Sanico and his secretary Janet Ahok, who are all under Senate detention order. Meanwhile, 4 adults and 9 children, including the 3 minors that SBSI leaders wanted to testify before the Senate last week, are now under the Interagency Council Against Trafficking. The 3 minors are still under assessment by the Department of Social Welfare and Development. Ontiveros also welcomes the Environment Department's order to suspend its lease agreement with SBSI over a 353-hectare land.
Kung bababa din yung mga adults, kabilang yung mga magulang nitong mga bata, ikasisiya din po talaga nila, kasi sabi nila sa ginawa ni na Señor Aguila sa kanila na pinakasal yung mga magulang nila sa ibang mga tao, kahit sila'y kasal pa rin at kasal din yung pinakasal sa kanila. Dahil doon ay nasira yung kanilang mga pamilya.
The senator is also confident that aside from Surigao del Norte's political leaders, the national government will also come up with programs that would help SBSI members to peacefully reintegrate themselves to their community. Back in Sitio Capihan, alias James, father of a 12-year-old who testified in a Senate hearing last week, filed a petition for writ of habeas corpus to recover his child.
Ang gusto ko lang ituwid sa tamang paraan. Dahil alam ko ang kanyang anong ugali, sir. Ama ako.
He was surprised to learn that his child went to his mother and is now giving a false story about the SBSI.
Tinuturoan namin dahil ito sa pandemic, hindi pa na sila nakatungo ng formal education. Pero yung anak ko, kahit nasa dito kami, is modular, pina-enroll ko ng regular class. Ako mismo ang nagturo sa aking bata.
A lower court hearing in Siargao was held Monday afternoon, but the parent petitioners and their lawyers were a no-show. Sherrianne Torres, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine State Health Insurer admits personal data of some of its members were compromised in a cyber attack on its online system. Joyce Balancho reports.
After earlier calling the threat of hackers a bluff, the Philippine Health Insurance Corporation now admits some patient information like name, address, date of birth, phone number, and PhilHealth identification numbers were compromised. Hackers earlier threatened to leak data that they have taken from the state insurer system after its attack using the Medusa ransomware. PhilHealth says the number of affected records is still undetermined, but it is working to notify all affected individuals directly. Members are also advised to take the following steps as a precaution. Monitor their credit reports for any unauthorized activity. Place a fraud alert on their credit reports. Change their passwords for all online accounts. And be wary of phishing emails. PhilHealth apologizes for the inconvenience. In a press briefing Monday morning, PhilHealth President and Chief Executive Officer Emmanuel Ledesma Jr. maintained that no ransom money will be paid to hackers.
Isang araw na lang, diba? Antay na lang natin yung block nila kung lalabas, diba?
But the agency is anticipating that the group behind the attack may attempt to release distorted information through various channels. PhilHealth cautions the public against these deceptive actions and to promptly report any sensitive information found online or on social media to PhilHealth and the Department of Information and Communications Technology to prevent further dissemination.
Let's be vigilant lang. Hopefully, ma-determine na lang ng public, diba? What's right and what's not. No?
As of Monday, PhilHealth reported that 3 out of 8 external systems have been back online. Its corporate website, the member portal, and the e-claims. The state insurer and DICT have not yet identified the syndicate behind the attack, but have noted the weakness in the system that made it vulnerable to cyber attacks.
We have a current antivirus in general, antivirus, anti-cyber security, but it is not updated. So, and probably that's where the hackers came in, through that weakness. There were procurement issues. So, for me, the reason was a strict compliance with procurement rules and regulations. That's why we were not able to activate or continue with this system. That's why we were not able to update the system.
To address the recent attack, PhilHealth activated an incident response system and also approved an emergency procurement for added layer of cyber and information security. PhilHealth also recommended that a national task force be formed composed of agencies such as the DICT, the National Bureau of Investigation, the Philippine National Police, and other relevant government agencies to prevent cyber attacks and other threats to systems of all government offices. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
6 Navata City policemen now facing murder charges for the death of 17-year-old Jemboy Baltasar. The 6 policemen are accused of conspiring in Baltasar's death. Police had claimed they mistook Baltasar for a murder suspect during a pursuit operation. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla, meanwhile, said the decision to file a murder case against the cops underwent a thorough process. The Philippine Justice Department wants 3 local vloggers cited in contempt over their YouTube interviews of former Corrections Chief Gerald Bantag. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says they should be held accountable for interviewing a fugitive. Remulla did not identify the vloggers. There is a standing arrest warrant for Bantag, who faces charges for the deaths of broadcaster Percy Lapid and inmate June Villamor. Lapid's killing happened exactly 1 year ago to this day.
Ay mga taong hinahanap ng batas na hindi ho dapat binibigyan ng ganyang salita at ito po ay pamabastos sa korte. Sa proseso po ng batas. When somebody aids and abets a felon wanted by the court to be arrested, then it is an affront to the court.